I'm talking to you, who has never had a real job before in their life.
Send me your resume, because you have business cards.
I'm bringing the application back.
No hiring sign on the website, no hiring sign on the store. I got 3 applications, 1 job interview, and 1 job.
Yeah. Good luck.
I'll tell you the big secret, the easiest way to get a job. When it came to job searching, I was always very lost. I would Google, you know, hey, jobs near me, nothing comes up. You're gonna get job offers from months ago. You're gonna get job offers for real people that have real skills. And this is not who this video is for. We're not people with skills. I'm talking mainly to people like me, students, like high school, college, someone who's looking for a part-time job or like minimum wage sort of stuff. Yeah, there's not a lot of like fancy internships out there if that's what you're looking for. But if you just want a job, if you want to work, if you want something to do during COVID, if you need money, then what are you doing? You know, you can go get one right now. The way that you get a job, this is how I got my first job. You walk in a store, a business, whatever. You go in and you go to the front counter and you ask them if they're hiring. Me and my friend, we did this and we filmed it so that you could see it because more people need to know about this.
I'm just wondering if you guys were currently hiring.
Most places don't put up a hiring sign when they're hiring. They don't even put up a listing online.
Is that excuse me? Do you guys happen to be hiring right now?
I'm talking to my manager.
Yeah, that'd be great.
You guys can just fill this out and
give
it to me or
manager. Awesome. Thank you
Thank
so
you.
Much.
And that's it.
Me too.
Okay, that's kind of the one. Me too. I want to work there.
You will be surprised how many places you can walk into that will just give you a job application.
Oh my gosh, they're hired. We actually have a hiring sign.
Oh, okay.
If interested, send resume. Well, you can go ask too, but it does say that.
If there is a hiring sign, if it says apply online, go in.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, how are you?
I just saw your hiring sign.
Oh yeah, you can email the resume, or just give it to her boss over there.
Okay.
We can kind of talk to her today.
All right, could I just talk to her now?
Yeah.
Should I just email? Is that the best way, or what do you think?
That's how I got the job. I didn't email. I brought in my physical resume, and I left it, and they called me back.
Okay.
But I kept checking up there, but I prefer to talk to her, show your face, and say.
Okay, I'll do that.
And then say, alright, I'll email you my resume. So
thanks. Go. Yeah. Which one is she?
She's the one with the gray hair.
Do you like working here?
Flexible, really flexible.
It what?
It's really flexible.
Oh,
are you in college?
Yeah, I'm at Chapman. I'll go up there.
Yeah.
Thanks so much. Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
I was just asking about your sign outside.
Awesome. Yeah. We are hiring part-time. We're specifically looking for someone that has during the week availability.
Oh, yeah. I have that.
You do? Okay, awesome. Are you here at Chapman?
Yeah, I am.
Oh, awesome. Mm-hmm. Okay, send me your resume. Can you get a business card? I think we're still getting resumes in this week, so hopefully next weekend we should be getting some more interviews going.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Tell me your name.
Gwenna.
Gwenna?
Yeah.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah. Thanks so much.
Literally, just the more you can like get yourself out there, the more you can show people your face. Like, hey, I'm looking for a job. Look at me. Like, I'm normal. I'm not like a serial killer.
Hi, I just wondered if you guys were hiring.
Hiring?
Yeah.
Yeah, we are. So you can go on to buddhismramen.com.
Yeah.
Go ahead and just check out.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Just buddhismramen. Okay.
Okay. Perfect. Thank you.
I did this last summer. I got 3 applications, and 1 job interview, and 1 job. And guess what? That's all you need. 1 job.
Hi,
I just had a quick question.
Yeah.
I was wondering if you guys were hiring right now.
Not right now, sadly. I didn't have our hours, so.
If you aren't able to kind of go somewhere and walk around, if you don't have kind of a big hub area like that, you can call businesses. Just look on Google Maps. I think I called maybe 3 ice cream places, and the 3rd one said, oh yeah, we are hiring. Drive over, we can give you a job application. I know this seems daunting, if you've never done it before, to just walk into a store and be like, give me a job. Yeah, I was scared at first too. The 3 things I would say for tips for how to get yourself out there and things to remember while you're doing it for the first time. The first thing is, when you go out there, know what you want. I wanna listen to my own heart talking.
I need to count on myself instead. Why not? Don't like flowers?
No, I don't have the skills to get flowers.
You want a job, of course, but know kind of how many hours a week you want to work. Do you want to work weekends, weekdays, after school? Just have a general idea in your head. If you're someone with no experience, definitely look for things like gift shops, toy stores, cafes.
This is a pawn shop on it. I thought we're in a pawn shop.
The nail salon?
No,
you can't be a bartender. You have to do like all this training to be a bartender.
This is nice, a cafe.
Yeah, you should ask it.
Clothes stores that are like small, or maybe in a mall, not like a full-on restaurant. You can look there too, but they're probably gonna put you as a dishwasher. That's what happened to my brother. I would recommend just the smallest types of businesses you can find, but really just go into any place you could remotely see yourself working. You wanna be going into as many stores as possible, because the second thing to remember is to be looking for rejections. I'm not gonna stop till I get my shot. That's who
I am, that is my plan. We'll end up on top, you can bet on it, bet on it. I can see you working here.
Is it closed?
Yep, a closed locked store. That's where I could see myself working.
The biggest fear that anyone's gonna have going into this is someone saying no. You have to think of it as the more places that you find that are not hiring, the closer you are to finding that one place that is. You only need one job.
I had a question.
Yeah.
I was wondering if you guys were hiring?
No,
I'm okay. Thanks.
Thank you.
Perfect.
Strikeout.
That was perfect. That's all you need to do.
It's not as bad as other rejections in my life.
Both times that I've done this, I've gotten about 3 applications, 3 to 4. Kind of look for that sort of range. You're gonna wanna go to about a dozen stores. But always the more the better. The more options you have, the better. And the last thing, keep it short. Am I the type of guy who needs what I say? Bet on it, bet on it, bet on it, bet on it. Don't overcomplicate it. You go in there and you say one of these sentences.
Hi, I was wondering if you were currently hiring. Is that
excuse me? Do you guys happen to be hiring right now?
Hi, I just had a quick question.
Yeah.
I was wondering if you guys were hiring right now.
Get to the point quickly, tell them what you need, and get out. Say thank you so much if they do. If they don't, thank you so much anyways.
Not right now, sadly. I didn't have our hours, so.
All right, well, thanks anyway. So it's totally fine. Thank you.
Most people are gonna be really nice. I haven't had any experiences with someone being mad at me for asking if they're hiring.
Hi, I'm bringing the application back. Awesome, thank you.
No problem.
Bye.
I've definitely come across questions on job applications, especially when I first started applying to jobs, that I would be like, what does this mean? What are they looking for here? Well, me and my friend filmed a little tutorial sort of thing. We just kind of tell you like tips to make yourself more likely to get the job, how to like sell yourself a little bit. Abigail's filled out a lot of job applications and she's gotten all the jobs she's applied for. So if you want to watch that, just stick around for the next 5 seconds and you can see that.
We have our applications. How many did you get?
I got 3. I only care about 1.
Me too. 3, and I only want to actually apply. Well, we're applying to all of them that we got, right?
Yeah.
I'll do this one first. I think this is the antique shop one, right?
Yeah.
I would look good.
The place I'll never work, because I hate old things.
Do every application you get, even if you hate it. Because you never know.
Even though you'd probably say no if they called you.
Yeah. It's like, you just gotta throw things out there. Okay, let's start. Name. Last name first. Easy, I know that.
Is this good content?
I'll just edit out the boring part.
Oh, okay.
For like helping people out, like this is how you do it, you know.
Oh yeah, literally people. I'm learning how to as well, even though I've worked a lot.
We'll take like a little video of your application, since I already put something online, but to like show them what's on it.
Here's my social security number.
No.
Steal my identity, YouTube.
No, social security number.
I don't know mine, it's on my phone. Oh, I don't actually know it.
I'll skip to the parts that are like actually helpful for people like not knowing how to do this.
Yeah, like people know your address, know your phone number.
You need social security number, so you can't, this isn't gonna work if you're like an illegal immigrant or something.
It might in Joe Biden's America.
Here's the part that trips people up sometimes. Employment desired position. Sometimes when I was applying to these, I'm like, position, like what the heck am I supposed
anything.
To do?
Anything. Yeah, anything. That's what
so
you would
here's
write.
What I would recommend writing is something like part-time cashier.
That's what I wrote for Penny Candy when I got the job there. I wrote part-time cashier. And then Penny called me and she's like, you wrote part-time cashier? Part-time it's like sales a, representative.
Yeah, pawn shop. That was No, wasn't the pawn shop.
No, you don't write the, when it says position, you don't write the name of the place. Mm-hmm. You're gonna start with part-time unless you want full-time.
But if you're a kid, go to school, don't have a full-time job.
Yeah. You can do part-time sales representative, part-time cashier, part-time
retail associate.
Did I write that for this, for the pawn shop? Part-time
sales associate is good. Because you don't want to sound dumb.
Yeah, you don't want to write job.
Actually, I have a question about Watson's.
What?
When it says, what position are you applying for? I don't know what that job was.
Oh.
But they weren't cashiers. It was like a guy making like coffee.
Say, part-time cashier and...
No, but they weren't cashiers. They were like... waiters or something. I don't know. What were they? Be like, whatever those cute boys were. That's what I'm writing.
I mean, for Penny Candy Shop, like, they weren't just, like, working the cashiers, but I still did. So, they prepare food, and they prepare coffee. It's really just a cashier.
They were not cashiers.
I know, but if you don't know, you can just say that.
Server?
Part-time. Oh!
Server.
Food service? Food service associate?
I'm just gonna write food service.
Part-time food service. Or is there another place to talk about your hours?
Yeah, there is.
So just say food service.
Yeah, they know. Like, I walked in. Also, if you walked in, they like,
yeah. Uh-huh. Date you can start. Right, the soonest date you can.
Yes.
What's the date today? The 8th?
8th. Feel like the 9th. Yeah. Like, do the day after.
If so, may we inquire you for your present employer? Don't need to check that. So then it's got education history. We've got general information, like subject of special study, research/work. So I'm just going to write...
They don't care that much about that,
yeah,
though.
They don't
care. It's just more about, like, did you go to high school? Are you in college? Mm-hmm. But, like, they're not going to be like, oh, what are you studying? We can't hire you. Like,
exactly.
It doesn't matter.
Should I just write Chapman University?
Yeah, they're not going to be like, oh, yeah. She's X major. She'll get it.
Yeah. But you can also, this is also good, because you've filled out resumes before, so you know what you're doing here.
I know how to make a resume. Yeah. I know how to apply. I've just never, like, gone in and been like, hey. Hire me.
Yeah. Special training. I worked at a cash register before.
Yeah, like
that's what they're looking for.
Well, not for this kind of job, but if you were like a lifeguard, you could say you're like CPR certified.
Yeah.
Like some, mm-hmm. Yeah. It's just something relevant to the job at hand. Don't say like, I commute a cycle. Yeah, yeah.
Say sometimes they ask about old jobs too, so you don't want to like give too much information there if it's gonna ask you again.
Yeah, you gotta keep them interested.
Did they give us like 4 applications?
Oh, it's the same thing. They really wanted to hire us.
Like,
oh, okay. I was like, this seems strange.
I think
strangely.
They didn't know what they were doing. If anyone wants one,
it seems like
DM me on Instagram. We can like give these out to our friends.
Be our friend. We'll give you a job mm-hmm. application. Mm-hmm.
And then after special training, it says special skills.
Yeah,
cashier.
I don't think they care that much.
Yeah, I'll just make something up. Like I literally am pulling a blank. Organizational skills. Like,
yeah, like
I said that on application once. I was like, I'm good at organizing.
Yeah, that's communication skills.
Oh, good organization. That's a good one. For special skills, I'm gonna write organization communication. And for special training, I'm gonna write cashier and what's it called when you talk to people when you're at? There's like, customer something.
Write in the comments if you know. Type it in.
U.S. military or naval service? No.
Yep.
Rank.
No.
Don't fill it out.
Unless you're in the military.
Oh yeah, unless you're.
We love you.
Okay, 4 more employers. List below last 4 employers starting with last one first. But you can also write things like if you were a babysitter. If you're someone who is like...
Yeah, if you've never really worked before, that's good.
Yeah. If you haven't worked before, just say like...
Or like even if you've done like volunteer stuff, mm-hmm. just show that you're responsible and you're not like an idiot and you've done things.
Basically what I'm going to write, Penny Candy Shop or Candy Shop. And then I was a nanny all fall, basically like full time. Before that, I did like that. I was with like that film thing I did, even though I did it for like 3 days.
Still, it was like real experience. Yeah.
And even
they don't care about the timing mm-hmm. as much.
I said things. I did it like June to August because I did like 1 day in June and 1 day in August. You can just like stretch it a little.
Yeah.
They won't know.
They won't. They're not calling anybody.
I had one other thing. Oh my gosh. I had an internship for school at the State House. And I usually write that.
Yeah.
So it wasn't. They weren't like paying me, but you can still write
but
that.
But it's still work experience. Work doesn't
exactly.
have to necessarily mean you get paid.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Yes. Are you of legal age to serve alcohol in this state?
No.
No, I don't think so. I can look it up, but I don't know.
How many jobs have you had in the last 2 years? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 more. That's an interesting question because, like, what counts as a job?
I've had like 1,500 jobs in my life.
So if you've had no jobs in the past 2 years at all, like, you can be honest. But also, again, don't be afraid to stretch it. If you were babysitting, that counts as a job.
Just say like 2.
If you mowed the lawn for your mom, just be like, lawn worker.
Like, landscaping. Say landscaping.
Yeah. Just like, don't be afraid to make stuff up. Have you ever been terminated from a job?
Even if you have, I haven't. But like, don't be like, yes, I've been fired. I had friends that were fired and they never said they were fired in application. Oh. And then now they have jobs, so.
Perfect.
But I was not fired. I've never been fired.
Oh my gosh, here's another thing. With job duties, they ask you about like, what did you do on the job?
Oh, yeah.
Always make it sound really fancy. Like
even if it was a really stupid job, like, make it sound good.
And then it's also, it always wants you to put the phone number of the person you worked for. They probably won't call your old bosses.
I've never heard of someone calling the old bosses. I don't think they ever do. But if you had a bad experience, don't put it down.
Just don't put the number, but you can still put the job.
Oh yeah, yeah, just don't put the number. Because if it's realistic,
let's wait for
fire engines. It's realistic that you wouldn't know the number.
Yeah. So if you don't know things, it's fine. Just leave it blank. They don't care. Mm-hmm. Really, all they care about is the hours stuff, right? That's all they really care about
the work experience.
With the dates for old jobs, just stretch the truth or like, just say what 100%. You remember. Like, it doesn't have to be perfect. Like, August 2nd.
Yeah. They don't look for specific. It's like months. Mm-hmm. So it could be like July 31st and you quit August 3rd, but they don't know that. Mm-hmm. So.
When did you actually work there? It was 3 years ago, so it was 2017, so say it was like 2018.
I'll just say like September 2018
to, it would be to 2019. Does that interact with any of your other jobs?
Yeah, but I'll just have it end like right before.
She's saying it was more recent because it's like a relevant job, but they just asked for like her most recent jobs.
Yeah.
But she's handled a cash at a cash register before. So she wants to say like, hey, I know how to run a cash
register.
Yeah,
I can't say the same thing 50 times anyway.
Uh-huh. Because she said lifeguard, lifeguard, and then her other most recent job was lifeguard, so she doesn't want to say that again. So she's just saying, frozen yogurt job was actually 2 years ago and not 3 years ago, so that's like fine.
Even though I remember nothing from it.
What will you say if they ask you at the job interview?
I didn't lie, but like, I just remember like being miserable. Maybe I shouldn't apply for this job.
If you're bad at lying, don't lie on your resume.
I'm a great liar. I'm just saying, like, we gotta do some research. Can I put you as my emergency contact?
Oh my gosh, yes. Definitely do, because we live together. So it only makes sense.
Roommate.
Let's do one as an example. Okay, so my most recent job was a nanny. It was technically a babysitter, but like I say nanny because it sounds better.
Yeah, you're not gonna be babysitting.
It was like 30 hours a week. So
yeah, it was legit.
Yeah. So company name. If you're a babysitter, you obviously don't have a company. So I guess you just Mr. and Mrs.
No, you just leave it blank.
Just leave it blank. Okay. Address. Their house address?
Don't write the specific address, just write like town.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Okay. Position, nanny. Job duties. This is where you have to say things like, I was like a tutor, so I helped him with school.
Yep.
So I'll say like
assisted with academics.
Yeah, but also this is like a tiny box.
Oh yeah, it's
so I'm just gonna write
very
like,
small.
Tutoring, food preparation?
That's good. That's really good. Even though, like, not really.
Yeah, like I made him grilled cheese sandwiches. Did you handle money? I mean, I think they're asking, did you work with a cash register? So no.
No.
Name and title of direct supervisor. If this is a babysitting job, then yeah, you put the name of the person you're babysitting.
Okay.
They ask you your pay for your old job.
Oh, then be honest. Yes. Yeah.
But if they ask you to pay, like, what do you want for this job? Anything.
Because if you, I don't, why would you, like, yeah, just don't say. Yeah,
don't say like $20 an hour.
Yeah,
but
like,
also
no.
Don't sell yourself short and be like $7 an hour.
Yeah, so just say anything because then it's
and
balls in there.
They'll give you whatever.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, we should talk about hours. So people might not know like.
Oh yeah,
about
yeah,
hours,
yeah.
Because I know I was super confused the first time. I'm like, wait, what even is part time? Like, how many hours? 40 hours is a full time job and 20 is a part time
job
officially, right?
Yes.
Those are like the official numbers, but. Definitely don't write like 2 hours a week, they won't hire you. I'd say write at least 15, right?
Yeah, 10 to 15.
You can write 10 to 15, you can write 15 to 20.
Don't say 40 because you're a kid, go to school.
Oh, if you're not a kid. Sometimes like creepy old men.
Oh, creepy old men, get off the channel. That's what I'm telling you.
Mm-hmm. We got that. What are we gonna say?
What do you mean? What are we gonna?
For hours.
Oh, that's what I was curious about.
So we're taking online classes right now.
I'm gonna say 15.
Yeah, me too.
Because we probably won't even get 15 because it's COVID.
And I worked at Penny Candy like 15 to 20, and that was like a really manageable part-time job. Like, yeah, it doesn't fill up your life, but it's like something. So yeah.
What days did you work for that?
I worked like I had weird hours. Okay. I worked like Thursday, Friday, Saturday, like half the day each day, and so that would be like 15 to 20 hours, somewhere in that range.
Yeah, I'm gonna say 15.
You could work like 2 to 3 hours a day, would be around 15, right?
Yeah,
which is, yeah, like, don't write 40.
Yeah, unless you're psychotic. Yeah. But if you're psychotic, get off this channel.
I welcome psychotic people on my channel.
Okay.
Do you have reliable means of transportation to and from work for the days and times you're available?
Just say yes. Never say no to that. Like, mm-hmm, even if you can't drive yet, your mom or someone can drive, yeah, you. Don't be like, no. Never put something on an application that makes you seem less desirable. Like, for example, this question: are you available to work holidays and weekends? Just say yes. Like, you can always ask for the time off later, uh-huh, but just say yes to get hired.
No, yeah. Oh, like, with one exception. I think if you've actually broken the law, like you have to tell them.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, say that. But like,
that's the only thing. Do you plan to be in school or taking courses at any time? Yes.
Yes.
What commitments you have or do you anticipate that may affect your schedule? This is something you should also probably be honest about.
Oh yeah, don't be like, I have nothing going on. Yeah. But also don't make yourself seem super busy. It's like,
it's a balance.
It's between a total, like, balance.
Sharing enough so that they know like what your deal is and how much you're actually available, but not being like,
you don't want to give them reasons not to hire.
Yeah,
you.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's the main, uh-huh, thing.
Here's my experience with a job interview. Maybe we'll talk about job interviews later. Talk about it now?
Yeah, let's talk about it now.
Okay, yeah, yeah. So when I went into Penny Candy for a job interview, they were just like making nice conversation, and then they actually started asking about the jobs that I had written on the application.
Yeah.
So if you're gonna write something here, you wanna make sure that you actually have something to say about it and that what you're gonna say is gonna kinda match what's on the application. So they asked me about the TV job, right? The one I took away for 3 days, and they were like, oh, so like, what did you do? And I'm like, oh yeah, I helped out. I did a lot of like on set help, and I did like lockdowns and like helping out with equipment and just things like that. And they were like, oh cool. Like, they're not gonna ask you every detail, but make sure, yeah, you have something to say about it.
Don't be like, you never wanna be at a loss for words in a job, uh-huh, interview. And or in life, yeah, but especially in a job interview.
And don't write a job down that you literally like did like 10 years ago and you like know nothing about.
Yeah.
Or don't write, like, if you have nothing to say about it,
don't write it down.
Mm-hmm. Do you have anything, yeah, else to say about job interviews?
Just be really enthusiastic about the job and act like it's your dream job, even though like you might not care that much, but literally act like you're so excited to work there and like, oh my gosh, I'd be so grateful if you hired me. Like, be very into it.
Yeah, and if they ask you, oh, have you like been to the store before, be like, oh, like, yeah, I have. Even if you haven't, because, yeah, I don't think I've ever been to Penny Candy shop before in my life. And they were like, oh, have you been to the store? I'm like, yeah, because I went in when I asked for the application. So, like, yeah, I know. Oh, it's also really good to have questions. They love it when you have questions.
Oh yeah, no. Here's the number one question. So what do you like best about working here? They say at the end, like, do you have any questions for me? Oh, well, what do you like best about working here?
Oh, you mean ask them that.
Yes.
Oh, that's a good question.
Yeah, because a lot of times with like any interview, they'll say at the end, like, do you have any questions for me? And I'll be like, oh yeah. And then you ask some like really practical question, mm-hmm, like, oh, like, what's the hourly rate? And then you could also ask them like, what do you like best about working here? That always works.
That's
like,
good. I didn't know that.
Oh yeah, that works for college interviews, works for job interviews, it works for everything. As someone that's never gotten rejected from a job.
That's a good accomplishment. Mm-hmm. I think that's basically it, right?
Yeah, it's like asking if you have relatives.
Relatives who work there? TMS affiliated company? Yeah. It looks like they have some sort of like other company.
If you like don't know, just say no.
Foreign language skills.
If it seems too hard, maybe don't apply. Oh my gosh, this one is so hard. Professional license, funeral.
This is a long one. Usually they're one page double-sided.
Yeah,
like
you
this.
Want like this. You want this trash, like,
If you get a really long one, I mean, the really long one that I applied for last time, like, didn't accept me, so.
Yeah, sometimes a really long one can mean, like, if they're looking for someone with a lot of skills, and, like, if you're pretty new or young, there maybe it's, like, not for you. But, like, don't let it discourage you.
Oh, my gosh, let's talk about references. That's a good one.
Oh, yeah.
They usually say, like, you can't say immediate family members. So I think I said, like, this a family friend's mom, and then I said, I think I said my uncle, but yeah, just any family friend.
I have, like, yeah, I just, like, know people, but it can be people. Like, and it can be, like, literally anyone. And if you, just don't do your mom and dad.
Yeah, anyone except your mom and dad, right?
Literally,
like, a teacher, they probably won't even call them.
They don't call anybody.
Yeah,
that's, like, the whole point of it. They don't, they never call anybody, not for these, like, kind of jobs. A real job, maybe. We don't know.
Yeah. So write, like, a teacher, an aunt, an uncle, a grandparent.
Just don't do anybody with your same last name.
That's good. That's good. That's no one with your same last name. I think that's it. Should we finish filling these out and turn this off?
Yeah, we'll talk to you after we got jobs. Yes. Or, like, we hear from them or we have an interview. Mm-hmm.
We'll update. All right. Bye.
Bye.